Hi guys, so today I'm going to be talking about my RCMA foundations. A lot of you guys have been asking me to finally post this review, and I decided it's time. I'm going to show you guys a few things that I have from RCMA. It's the No Color Powder and the RCMA Thinner. I'm going to be writing detailed reviews about these, but to quickly mention, you basically need half a drop. A drop, I think, at sometimes is just way too much depending on how much product you're using. This thing is going to last you an extremely long time. It's only 1 ounce, but it's so powerful. Be careful. The RCMA No Powder 3 ounce is an amazing setting powder. I think that it's equal good as its more, let's call it a little bit expensive brand, not expensive, but a little bit more high up brand, Ket. So basically this is 2 ounces, this is 3 ounces. In the future, I'm going to be opting for this guy just because I think that they do the same thing and this guy is just cheaper. Another thing which I got was the RCMA White Foundation in 1 ounce. This is the 1 ounce packaging, which is excellent when you know the exact colors or shades which you need. This is going to last you quite a long time. I think that it's like there's a 2 year, I'm not really sure, but I think that it expires after 2 years, so basically cream foundations can last much longer. This is an oil cream based foundation. Then I also got, which I regret, I'm going to tell you why, I also got these foundations which you have like 5 shades in. They're called the RCMA series favorite palettes. I got the Shinto and I got the Olive. The only reason I regret for getting them is because this is my Graftopian palette. Basically, RCMA has the same thing. They have a Shinto 11 and they have a KO 10 and they have 18 shades in. And the palette like this big costs around like $70 or $75 depending on where you got it. I do know that I get all myself at Camera Ready Cosmetics, and I do know that right now these bigger sample palettes are on sale for $64, $65 if I'm not mistaken. So check that out. Basically, these guys cost $30, so when comparing price wise and how much product you get, so basically for 2 of these products and let's say max $10 more, you actually get 18 shades instead of 10. So I think that's a much better deal for us makeup artists. But if you want to get a foundation for yourself, this bigger sample palette would be too much for you guys, so just skip that. For personal use, I recommend you actually get the smaller palette, which has 5 shades, and it varies from a lighter to a darker shade. They have quite a few palettes. You can consult with Camera Ready Cosmetics sales team, who are excellent at what they do, and they will recommend a palette which they consider would suit you best. They're really great at recommending things. If you are certain that you know the shade you want but you still want to test out a few shades, you can also get by Camera Ready Cosmetics this size samples. I'm going to show you. This is a sample of how much I got inside. This is my Graftopian Muted Green sample. I got that because I wanted to see if I was going to get those, the color corrector palette. Talk about that another time. So basically those are the size, and I also got from RCMA the contour, actually the highlight and contour palettes. You have like 3 highlighting shades. You have the yellow, pink, skin color, and then the darker one and the lighter one. They also have a bigger palette of the KO 10 and the Shinto 11 palette. It comes, I think it's as thick as this, the guy here, and it is just this size like that, but it's much thicker so more product fits in it. So then if you like that palette, you can actually get the full size palette. Okay, so now a lot of you guys have been wondering how to apply this foundation. A lot of people like this foundation. A lot of people use it for not only for beauty shoots, but also for like bridal and so on. I don't know if I'm going to color match myself correctly just because I have not yet used this palette, but based on a lot of information that I got online, I was led to believe that this would contain my skin color. Okay, so first things, I've wrote down a few things you have to know. That this foundation is a pro foundation, which means you're probably going to have to mix and match to find your shade. It doesn't have to mean so. That's why I do recommend getting these 5 series palettes, because within this, for example, if you're olive or yellow, this is more olive. This is more of an olive palette. So if you're olive and you're not really sure which shade to get, but you do range between these shades, then within this palette, you're going to be able to find your own shade, maybe mixing them, maybe one of the shades, etc. These products are one of those rare products which contains 50% of pigment, which means that the color is going to be very true to what you see here. mirror. So basically you lean it against your face, you're like, okay, that's my shade right there. It's going to be easier to find your color. Also, the coverage is light to full and true full. Basically, if you're using the RCMA thinner, you're going to be able to thin it down so that it goes into a lighter coverage, but make sure to not overuse this or it's going to give an oily effect. The finishing end result of this foundation is a true matte, so people with oily skin are going to benefit most out of this foundation. If you have drier skin, I do recommend using a face cream. I recommend getting this moisturizer, which you can also get at Camera Ready Cosmetics. It's probably the best. This is for all skin types. It offers 24-hour hydration, and it probably plays best with the RCMA foundation. So prepping your skin, we're gonna have to do that too. Also, another thing which I wanted to mention, so even if you have very dry skin, you can still use this foundation. You just gotta prep your skin very well. And I do recommend for very dry skin or dry skin to actually use the thinner, because it's going to give additional hydration and moisture and a little bit better slip to the foundation, so it doesn't adhere to all the dry patches or such like that. The foundation, when applied properly, it looks like second skin. You will not recognize that you have foundation on your skin. We're going for that today, but as I said, I'm not sure if I have the color shades for my skin tone. We'll figure that out a little bit later. And the last thing, which is really important, is that you make sure that you set it with a powder. So if you don't set it with powder, it's going to go into your creases, it's going to move. All cream foundation, whether they be wax-based, oil-based, or silicone-based, they all have to be set. I recommend getting a powder puff. This is my Camera Ready Cosmetics powder puff, which I bought at also Camera Ready Cosmetics. You can set it with a powder puff. Okay, so I wanted to mention what I mixed. I basically took the Shinto palette, I took a little bit of SH1, I took my contour and highlight palette, I took YH1, and I did a combination of GB and OL2 to get a color which is closest possible to my skin tone. Okay, so now I mix up a batch on the back of my palette. The foundation might be off a little bit, I'm not really sure, but we'll see. So it's most important to prime your skin, so I'm going to be using this moisturizer cream. I'm gonna take this combination and we're going to be applying it on half of my face. And I'm going to be using a little bit of my RCMA thinner to basically thin it a little bit. So I have like one drop right there. It's like right there, one drop. And I'm just gonna be mixing it in. Look at that, one drop, it makes it super liquidy. It's crazy. So I'm mixing it in with my foundation and I'm actually going to use my spatula. I'm just gonna apply it like this on my face. So now I'm taking my single brush in F60 and I'm going to be applying a little bit of moisture spray on it, the Cinema Secret Moisture Spray. And then I'm just gonna take my brush. A lot of product I applied, I can just see that right now. It's so pigmented that this is like a crazy amount of product. This foundation with the thinner glides on like butter, and as I said, even the one drop that I had was way too much. I'm going to be picking up a bit more with my brush and just going over the places that need some extra coverage. Okay, so you basically cannot see the foundation. You can also go over your ear a little bit. It blends perfectly into my skin. I'm hoping that this is picking up the camera correctly. And so this is basically the side right here, which has been thinned down. So the foundation has been thinned down with the RCMA thinner, just so that we make the foundation like very thin and that we glide on the face. As you can see, when you're using the thinner, you can use a brush and just basically blend it into the face. This side, can already see the difference, quite amazing. This side we're going to be applying a little bit of like a medium to heavy coverage, and we're not going to be thinning down the foundation, and let's see what happens. So if you don't warm up this foundation, so we're applying the heavier side right here, it's going to be very hard to work with. And when I say warm up the foundation, I mean work it really into your palette until you see it getting softer and much more obedient, let's put it like that. This is going to be heavier coverage. You're gonna notice that right away, maybe. I notice it right away that this coverage is heavier. I'm actually really liking this foundation. So this is the first time I'm using it on myself. It really glides on amazing when you warm it up. So this side right here, as I said, does not have any thinner in it. it's just really worked well. So basically I really pushed it well into my Meta palette. I worked it, I spent it, I hit it. Basically it sounds like I'm trying to make butter out of my foundation. But basically when you really warm up that proper really well, it glides on like butter. So basically you did make butter. So as you can notice, this side really does have more coverage. Okay, so now looking at both of the sides, as you can notice, this side right here, you cannot see this on camera, does have a little heavier coverage than this side, but not as much heavier, because this one we thinned down with the thinner and you can see the dewiness in the foundation. That's what the thinner does, and it kind of doesn't give that full math. While this side, also because I just applied my cream and waited like only 3 minutes, I didn't use the thinner, but I could have come in contact with it because I used the same brush. So that's why this side is not like super matte, but it does look very natural matte. And now to blend this foundation in even better, I'm going to be using my BB cream, Beauty Blender. I'm just gonna bounce it around just so there's no streaks. I don't know if you guys can see, I wanted to zoom in quite well. The foundation looks like second skin. Hopefully I'm gonna be able to zoom this in without distorting the pixels, but look at that. The thinner gives such a beautiful dewiness. It's crazy, man. This side right here, I do believe that maybe from the brush a little bit of a thinner went, and that's why it's not like super matte, but the foundation does have a matte finish, and this one has a little bit dewiness, but it doesn't matter. So this one was just thinned lightly because of the residue of the thinner in the foundation brush, but still it looks amazing. I probably have not used a better foundation in my life. This is crazy. Okay, so before I set this, I want to use my contouring and highlighting palette so you guys can see how I use that. So now I'm going to be doing contouring and highlighting. So I'm going to be using contouring and highlighting palette. I'm going to be using the YH1 and CS1, and I'm going to be mixing the two. I'm going to use the same brush that I use for my skin. Whoop, maybe have made it too light. So now I'm going to be using the contour shade. I'm actually going to be using the lighter one, so I'm doing like a mild contouring. And using the same brush, I don't see why not. And we're going to be applying the contour shade. Then I'm going to take my Moist Beauty Blender, and I'm just gonna bounce it and blend this guy in. And just wanted to mention, this contouring and highlighting is day makeup because I'm going out. So I'm now going to be doing that very crazy, let's call it Kim Kardashian contouring. Okay, so there it is. I know that some of you might not be picking up on the contour and highlighting shades which I applied. I just did want to mention that this is my day contouring and highlighting, which looks extremely subtle. For day contouring and highlighting, you really don't want to make it noticeable. All right, so the last thing is setting the foundation. I'm going to be using my Cinema Secrets powder puff, which is packed with powder. And I'm just going to be setting the foundation. It's all about press and roll. Thank you guys so much for watching. This completes the review. As you've heard, those are just some of the things which I wanted to mention about RCMA on my website, smashingbeauty.com. You can find a detailed review of the products which I have mentioned in this video. And I'm going to be doing swatches. I'm also going to be doing more detailed information about this foundation. You can get this foundation at Camera Ready Cosmetics. You can also get samples. You can get the sample palettes, the big sample palette, or you can actually get those small little jar samples, whatever rocks your boat. I also do recommend getting this cream, moisturizer for your face so that you make sure that your skin is prepped. The thinner will help you thin the foundation really and make it like very liquidy, but as I did mention, you really need half a drop to maximum a drop of this to be able to work with it so that the foundation doesn't turn more oily. The foundation is on the dry side and it's oil based mainly, and it's 50% of pigments. And if you do have a very dry skin or dry skin, you will need this thinner because it's going to actually help the foundation glide around really well and not adhere to any dry patches or so on. Thank you guys so much for watching. I know there's a lot of information. Hopefully this wasn't too confusing. Again, as I mentioned, go to smashingbeauty.com for more detailed review, more swatches, and information about all the products which I mentioned today. And and hopefully this will help you decide is RCMA for you or not. If you are uncertain, maybe you're trying to look which palette to get or something like that, leave a comment below. Feel free to ask me, or you can directly contact Camera Ready Cosmetics and ask them. They have an excellent team of makeup artists and people that understand this foundation. Thanks to them, I have gotten the two foundations which I'm very happy with. That's excellent. And I think that this guy is crazy. It's a must. Thank you guys once more, and I will see you Mondays and Thursdays. And don't forget to check out my other tutorials, SFX, Halloween, and other reviews. You can go on my front page of my channel, and you're going to see playlists, and you're going to find certainly something more interesting to watch. See you on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Bye, guys.